Greetings fellow Earthlings, welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Global Enforcement. Ahead of us is the mission finale called Scorched Earth, or rather the campaign finale. Operation finale. I mean, it is going to mark sort of the end of the campaign as well, except for one tie-up mission. Anyhow, we are running ahead of ourselves here. Intelligence shows that the UF is preparing to launch a nuclear weapon immediately. Return to the launch facility and secure the missile before it can be launched. Now, some backstory here. The hostages that we secured in mission control, pretty much know the layout of this nuclear, or rather just this missile launch facility. That kind of information the Delta Force does not have, or pretty much any other intelligence agency that, you know, is owned by the US. None of them have that kind of intelligence. So, we rescue some hostages from mission control, and they are in turn helping us navigate through the maze-like structures of Mission Scorched Earth. Now, I have a feeling that this is going to be a brutal mission, given the fact that it is the operation finale. So, let's go and check it out.
This is it. United Freedom has begun their countdown for launch. The rescued hostages have given us a layout of the gantry and launch control. In keeping with their Scorched Earth policy, UF is likely to detonate the device regardless of the group's survival. You are ordered to proceed to Objective Wraith and eliminate all hostiles. Your insertion point will be 430 meters southeast of the launch control building. You'll have to cross a road patrolled by tanks and infantry, but don't get caught up in a firefight. Time is critical. After clearing launch control, move north to the gantry itself and secure it to prevent a manual detonation of the weapon. Once the area is secured, a DOE nuclear emergency search team will follow up immediately to disarm the device. Everything's riding on this one. Good luck.
This is King 6. Intel reports that the missile is in the launch facility. Clear Objective Wraith of all hostiles.
Roger, King 6. Attempt number 21. Good on you for you guys for stopping. I mean, you made it possible to kill yourself. If only you guys had not stopped, you guys would not have died. But guess what? You guys stopped, and as a result, you guys are dead. Which is amazing in my opinion, because this would not have been possible without your aid. Did I accidentally, like, drop two barrels there? Okay, I better switch back to single shot, because that guy's a guy. Why is that guy not dying? Come on, die.
You have a tank and foot soldiers on the road to the north. Take them out and continue.
Roger, King 6. I will do that as soon as I get to. I wonder if that guy over there is dead yet. Can I not zoom in? Apparently not. Oh, there you are. Nice of you to show up. Honestly. You're not dead. You both are now dead. Amazing. Well, 14 mags of this gun are enough, in my opinion. Not that anybody asked, but yeah. They're enough to kill whoever needs to be killed. I mean, don't get me wrong, this game makes it far easier to spot enemies from afar, but it is still a little lacking. There are times when you can't really tell what is an enemy and what is not. I wonder who is shooting at who right now. But yeah, as we go up here, we will notice multiple hostiles that we need to take out. Apparently somebody is still up there shooting at somebody. Charlie is down, Alpha is not, so I'm guessing they're probably shooting at Alpha at this point. Don't know whether that is Alpha 1 or 2, but either of them.
Careful, Bravo. The complex is heavily guarded.
Funny thing is, they won't be at it for too long. Because I'm here to make sure that everybody who's shooting at anybody is dead. Alpha 1, be very careful. These guys are no joke. Be very careful indeed. Now who the hell are you guys shooting at? Is what I want to know. There are of course two guys in there.
Bravo, move in and clear the building.
Roger King 6, on it. Nobody here. There's going to be a guy there who runs across the field, who we need to shoot out. And there will be another guy who comes running from that bunker over there. And there will be a guy right here that we need to take out. Did you die or did I? Yes, you're dead. Cool. Now that that's done, let's check like a bunch of grenades in there. And there's only one guy in there that we can actually take out without the use of grenades. I'm just gonna lay prone here until the frames return. And well, we need to go upstairs and shoot somebody dead. But the previous time around that I tried that, I got snapped through the back by another person. And I'm essentially trying to avoid that fate this time around. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take him out first, before he can take me out. That's never supposed to happen, like the other guy taking me out, but well, it happened the last time around, so. Yeah. You never know how this game is gonna go, to be honest. So where's this guy? There's supposed to be a guy right here. Did that guy somehow come down? I suppose that is the only plausible explanation, that the other guy came down. Alright, time for us to head down and we'll take a wide berth. Just gonna check behind here for an enemy. Yep, just confirming that he was taken out. And he has in fact been taken out. Now, hopefully this is not laser guided. No, it is not. And that law has also been taken out of the game. Now, there are a couple of enemies here. Let me go ahead and take them out. Take them out first this time around, because the last time around I actually went down there without bothering to take them out, and they turned out to be, well, quick shots. Eliminating me in the beat of my heart. There are more enemies here that I'm scouting for. I guess we'll find them with time. Oh yeah, that's, I suppose, is where they are. Zeroed in for 200 meters, we start shooting. And we don't stop shooting until we get everybody on this here map. I'm mostly just taking out the snipers that are going to be a threat to us. We're not going to take out any of the other ones. Frames lagging again. Luckily for us, there's nobody on top of the control tower. What there is a person right next to it and on the ground floor. And after we take this guy out,
Bravo King 6, the control center is clear. Move north and sweep the launch area.
Roger King 6. Instead of sweeping it though, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna mark it to be eliminated using an artillery strike.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Fire mission on the way. Copperhead is on the way, rather. I think that is the name of a plane. I wonder why it is named like a snake. Maybe that's just how fast it strikes. And it takes out literally everybody down there. Our job is done for us. And I'm just gonna wait for that guy to run back along this way before I shoot him too. You are going to come back, right? Yes, you are. Good boy. I do not think there is anybody else remaining here. Not as far as I recall. So Alpha 1 and... Ooh, Alpha Team is still alive. That's amazing. Nice. Anyway, that's where we came from. And that's where we go. No, there were two enemies down there. We have already taken them out. Are these guys dead? Yes, they are. Those guys are also dead. So who's remaining? Why is the mission not over yet? No, that's just a blown up tree. That is the dead BRDM. I recall there being nobody on the inside. So what happened is around attempt number 13, I hit the... You know, I completely cleared out the... the missile site. And that is when King 6 told me, the missile site is clear, now clear the launch tower as well. And at that point in time, I could not help but make the Pikachu face, because nowhere was it ever detailed to us that we are supposed to get rid of the other site too. But at this point in time, I have played and replayed this mission over and over enough to the point where... I think it is now practically muscle memory. And we already did receive confirmation that we have cleared this area out, so yeah, I don't think there is anybody in here. Like, we have cleared the area over there out, so I don't think there's anybody in there that we need to be cautious of at the very least. I guess all that remains is to reach it. I was sort of expecting King 6 to make an announcement, but I guess we'll just let the folks at Alpha, in Fireteam Alpha, check it out for us. I'm honestly just proning here to reduce fall damage as well. Because this game sucks at reducing the fall damage for you. I do believe we have taken everybody out, because Alpha could not clear out a goddamn... Well, let's just say Alpha could not clear out anything if his life depended on it. And, well, he cannot, actually.
Excellent work, Bravo. A team is standing by to disarm the weapon.
Roger King 6, we will await the team's arrival and... protect this facility from further attack. This is Bravo 1, over and out. Finally, we have completed the final mission of Operation Global Enforcement, Scorched Earth, and my god, was this frustrating. And you know what, just give me a second there. I began playing this mission at 12 o'clock, and it took me 21 attempts, and it's past 3 right now in the morning. And it just literally took all this time for me to complete this one mission called Scorched Earth because of just how finicky it was. I mean, I think the briefing actually told us to avoid encounters with some of the enemies. Briefing, and I'll just stop the briefing.
This is
here.
It.
Yeah. So United Freedom, because the countdown gantry and launch control. Drop order to proceed to objective wraith and eliminate all hostiles. See, objective wraith is right here. That's a missile site, not the control site right here. Eliminate all hostiles. Are they perhaps talking about proceeding to objective wraith through these waypoints and then eliminating everybody you meet? You'll have to cross a road patrol by tanks and infantry, but don't get caught up in a firefight. I see. Now this line here is what I took to mean that we should not be attacking this facility either. But that's what I was... Yeah, after clearing launch control, move north and secure the gantry to prevent a manual detonation of the weapon. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I got confused with. I thought that we are not supposed to get into a firefight with these guys. And even when we press B inside the game, which button might be different. I think it was Q by default. But yeah, it tells you about your mission orders. And even that sort of tells us to just clear objective wraith and then all enemies in and around objective wraith. And that's all you need to do, apparently. But turns out even that is incorrect because, well, that didn't work for us either. So, around the 13th try, I eliminated everybody at objective wraith, and then King 6 tells us that the missile site is secure, but we still need to get back to, well, clearing the the mission control, I suppose. Yeah, clearing the mission control out. So yeah, this was a frustrating level, lots of variables, and very requires a lot of finesse, actually, basically, is what I'm trying to say. This level requires a ton of finesse. Anyhow, I thought I might attempt, 4 horsemen as well today, but as it turns out, it is actually quite late. Let's see, maybe I might have the energy for it after a short break. But, for you guys, as far as Mission Squad Truth is concerned, this is it. And it might actually seem like I blazed through this mission, but that remember the fact that I have been retrying this for the past 21 times, and that's just it's just perfection through practice is all I can say about this run through. So with that being said, the next time we'll come back, we will be covering the bonus mission, or rather the secret mission for Operation Global Enforcement called 4 Horsemen, wherein we need to assist Spetsnaz in freeing their captured Russian general. Anyhow, this is it for today. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.